Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. This morning, SpaceX successfully launched their 77th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 7-6.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Starlink 7-6. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1075, then landed successfully for the seventh time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 2 FTS has saved.
Landing leg deploy.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Coming up later today, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 625 mission is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 29th at 11:45pm UTC or 7:45pm EDT. Then, going into next week, we can hopefully expect to see yet another Starlink launch. The Starlink 626 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday, November 2nd at 10:48pm UTC or 6:48pm EDT. There was an article posted regarding more satellites that SpaceX will be launching. It says, MDA, a leading provider of advanced technology and services to the rapidly expanding global space industry, announced today at its Earth Insight customer conference that it has selected SpaceX to be the launch service provider for Chorus, MDA's next generation Earth observation constellation. There's been a slight delay to the Intuitive Machines lunar lander mission. They posted an article saying Intuitive Machines has announced that in coordination with SpaceX, liftoff of the IM-1 lunar mission is now targeted for a multi-day launch window which opens January 12, 2024. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. In addition to the full stack testing SpaceX did, they also did multiple water deluge tests. Work was seen going on at the top of the launch tower. Groundwork has been seen going on at the suborbital tank farm. There was a post about updated information from the Fish and Wildlife Service regarding Starship. It says, updated statement from the FWS regarding the Starship status. On October 19th, FWS reinitiated consultation with the FAA about the Endangered Species Act. While the FWS has 135 days to issue an amended opinion, they do not expect to take the full time. The HLS nose cone was seen moved to the production site. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.